Vanity Fair, or A Novel Without a Hero by William Makepeace Thackeray. In this novel, we have two major characters. Becky Sharp is a poor orphan of low birth. By her cunning schemes, she tries to raise herself to the upper limits of high society and wealth. Amelia Sidley is a soft, naive young woman who is born into wealth, comfort, and the protective arms of practically anyone who comes into contact with her. Amelia Sidley, of a good family, and Rebecca Sharp, an orphan, leave Miss Pinkerton Academy of Chiswick Mall to live out their lives in Vanity Fair, the world of social climbing and search for wealth. Amelia does not esteem the values of Vanity Fair. Rebecca cares for nothing less. Becky first attempts to enter the sacred domain of Vanity Fair by inducing Joseph Sidley, Amelia's brother, to marry her. Joss Sidley turns out to be a whole other kettle of fish, fat, vain, super shy around girls, and in general, quite a character. Yet, she goes on with her plan. George Osborne, however, foils this plan. He intends to marry Amelia and does not want a governess for a sister-in-law. William Dobbin, George's close army friend, takes one look at Amelia and falls head over heels, but keeps his feelings a secret. Becky leaves the Sidleys and goes to the Queen's Crawley estate to be a governess. She makes the best of her situation there and becomes really close to Mrs. Crawley. In addition to teaching the Crawley children, Becky becomes the secretary and informal estate manager to Sir Pitt Crawley. Later on, Becky marries Rawdon Crawley, second son of Sir Pitt Crawley. Because of his marriage, Rawdon's rich aunt disinherits him. First introduced as a friend of George Osborne, William Dobbin becomes the instrument for getting George to marry Amelia after George's father has forbidden the marriage on account of the Sidleys' loss of fortune. Because of George's marriage, old Osborne disinherits him. Both young couples endeavor to live without sufficient funds. George dies at Waterloo. Amelia would have starved but for William Dobbin's anonymous contribution to her welfare. Joseph goes back to his post in India, claiming such valor at Waterloo that he earns the nickname Waterloo Sidley. Actually, he fled at the sound of the cannon. Both Rebecca and Amelia give birth to sons. Becky claims she will make Rawdon's fortune, but actually she hides much of her loot obtained from admiring gentlemen. When she becomes the favorite of the great Lord Steyne, she accumulates both money and diamonds. In the meantime, innocent Rawdon draws closer to Lady Jane, wife of Rawdon's older brother, Pitt, who has inherited from the rich aunt. When Rawdon discovers Becky in her treachery, he is convinced that money means more to her than he or the son whom she has always hated. He refuses to see her again and takes post in Coventry Island, where he dies of yellow fever. Because her parents are starving and she can neither provide for them nor give little Georgie what she thinks he needs, Amelia gives up her son to his grandfather Osborne. William Dobbin comes back from the service, reconciles old Osborne to Amelia, whereat Osborne makes a will, leaving Georgie half of his fortune and providing for Amelia. Becky, having lost the respectability of a husband, wanders in Europe for a couple of years and finally meets Joseph, Georgie, Amelia, and William on the continent. Rebecca sets about to finish what she started to do at the first of the book, that is, to ensnare Joseph. She does not marry him, but she takes all his money and he dies in terror of her, the implication being that she has, at least, hastened his death. At the end of the book, Becky has the money necessary to live in Vanity Fair. She appears to be respectable. Becky takes pity on Amelia and shows her the note that George wrote Becky about running away together the night before he went to fight Napoleon. Amelia is shocked at this betrayal, but feels released from the marriage, and writes to Dobbin, who returns immediately and marries her. They go back to London, where Amelia has a daughter. Little Rodden, upon the death of his uncle Pitt and his cousin Pitt, becomes the heir of Queen's Crawley. Little George, through the kindness of Dauphin, has lost his distorted values obtained in Vanity Fair. The reader feels that these young persons of the third generation will be better people than their predecessors in Vanity Fair. The end.